Bruins lose 5-2 to the Philadelphia Flyers. The Philadelphia Flyers. We're 0-2 to start the season, and if we're going to play like this against the same teams, we're going to lose, and we're not going to make the playoffs because we play, I don't know if you know this, we play the Flyers 8 times this season. Not only the Flyers, but the Bruins, the Capitals, the up-and-coming Rangers, the Islanders, the Sabres, I guess, the Devils. If we play like we did tonight, for the majority of how we played tonight, we're not making the playoffs. This was a tough game to watch, especially with how great the second half of the first period went. We had like a mini comeback there. Yeah, woohoo! And then nothing happened. I swear to God, if we take as many penalties as we took tonight in any game for the rest of the season, I'm turning off the fucking television. It was ridiculous. Zucker took a bad penalty. McCann took a bad penalty. This is two straight nights now where we've had too many men on the ice. That's unacceptable, especially against a team like Philly, who has guys like Travis Konechny. Yes, Philly, I fucking hate Philly. I'm a Penguins fan, of course, but Travis Konechny had a fucking hat trick tonight. A couple of them goals came on the power play. Let's start off here with lines before I get even more angry and start throwing stuff. Only one lineup change from Thursday. When was the last game? Wednesday to now. And that being Cody Ceci's a scratch. Chad Ruedel gets in. I didn't think CeCe was the worst defenseman the Penguins had on opening night. I thought it was Matheson. I kind of titled my first PFR after how he didn't have the best games. But he wasn't as bad as someone else tonight, which we'll get to later. He was on the ice for all 5 freaking goals. Anyways, no Kapanen. Jari got the start. Of course, he didn't play the rest of the game. Also of note, Sean Couturier. 2 shifts in, he got hit by Jared McCann. Didn't seem like a big hit at all, like a nasty hit. He left the game. And honestly, in my opinion, Sean Couturier might be the best Philadelphia Flyer. So Penguins should totally take advantage of that. Let's see if they did. No, 3 goals scored on them in the first. There was a brief 5-on-3 for Philly. And this goes back to the Penguins taking too many penalties. It's unacceptable, the amount of penalties that we took tonight. Chad Ruedel, and then a too many men penalty caused the Penguins just a brief 9-second 5-on-3, but then the Penguins were scrambling, and then the puck goes in front of the net, connecting the Flyers capitalized. Tic-tac-toe play. Not much you're going to do about that. Next couple of plays later, Travis Konechny gets a second, and Bob Airey was not very happy about this, and honestly, I wasn't either, and that is why this is our first bad call brick of the 2021 season. Travis Konechny kicked that puck in. If he didn't intentionally, obviously it's not a goal. Even if he didn't do it intentionally, I don't know. They didn't really even review it, though. There was no challenge on the play. It's all right. Nothing much you can do about that. Netmouth scramble. Went off a skate. Unfortunate. The Penguins got to generate some offense here, except they don't. And Ivan Provorov gets an easy shot there. Jari probably could have stopped that one. The Penguins were out of position on this one, though. And Tristan Jari is pulled 3 goals in just about halfway through the first period. Casey DeSmith comes in. And this was mostly a goaltending change due to, a momentum shift. Jari wasn't terrible in this. He really only had maybe the 3rd goal that could be blamed on him. A goaltender's changed for momentum reasons, and that's exactly what happened. Sidney Crosby and the Penguins get a power play, and then Crosby, buries one off of the makeup call. Momentum is now on the way for the Penguins, and then Brandon Tanev, who is probably my favorite player on the Penguins right now, and Mark Jankowski, that 3rd line was fucking phenomenal, not just 2 nights ago, but tonight. They score off the rush right after Sid's goal. Things are going the Penguins' way. Hopefully there's a comeback here as we go into the first intermission. Even better, Zucker and Guentzel, they both draw penalties in the later stages, and there's a penalty going to be carried over to the second period. Maybe the Penguins can score off of it and tie the game up. Also, the Flyers were getting a little angry towards the end there, a little bit extracurricular. Of course, it is the Battle of Pennsylvania, but things are to be expected. But also, I don't know, momentum's going the Penguins' way. Maybe we got a good game going on here, except we didn't. In the second period, there was so many chances for the Penguins, and they really did control the play for a good majority of the time, but I cannot tell you how many chances Evan Rodriguez, Jason Zucker, and even Jake Guentzel just missed off the rush. Really the only players that seemed to be consistently getting those scoring chances was the 3rd line with Jared McCann, who had a phenomenal game tonight, in my opinion, Mark Jankowski, and Brandon Tanev. Brandon Tanev, MVP for the Penguins so far in 2 games, and his headshot is adding to that status. But then we take so many goddamn penalties. Mike Matheson, he gets lazy. Jankowski and company kill it. We did have some good shorthanded chances, and that obviously has to do with the fact that, you know, our third line, our best line right now, Jankowski, Tanev, McCann, some of those guys are the penalty killers. Even Chad Ruggedel jumped up on the play a couple times tonight, who this is his first game since like 2019. Him and Casey DeSmith both got in the lineup since a really long time. Overall, though, going into the third period, I kind of got a little like meta and had like a sad just thought overall. This is fun, obviously, watching hockey just with the Penguins Flyers. It's obviously always going to be fun no matter what. But this was a good game through two periods, and I really just didn't feel it, if you know what I mean, because there's no fans. It's almost February, and I don't know. I can't speak for everyone here, but this season's going to be tough to get through, not only because, you know, if the Penguins play like this, but also it's just, I don't know, the atmosphere's not the same. And of course, I'm not at the building. I'm not in Wells Fargo right now. I can't tell you what it's like for the players, but there's something different about it. I mean, Sidney Crosby may even play better when Flyers fans say Crosby sucks. So it'll be different this year. Now, the other main issue that I had with tonight's game is that the big guns outside of Crosby, of course, who will always be, you know, giving us everything every shift. The big guns, Zucker, Gensel, Malkin, Letang, and Brian Rust, they were not producing. There's a difference between not producing, or there's a difference between generating scoring chances and not producing at all. Sometimes there were some decent scoring chances with Gensel, maybe, because, you know, Crosby was setting him up, but goddamn. Milk cartons are going to be out soon over a wanted poster for a Have You Seen This Man poster for Evgeny Malkin here. He is just been invisible these past couple of games. And no, Crosby cannot get injured this season for you to go on a tear. That's not how it's going to work. Please. Because, you know, when Malkin goes on his tears, it's when Sid is hurt and he has to be the number one center. This is a really weird analogy, but I thought of it in the game. I remember when my little sister was like a baby, like toddler. She had one of these toys, and it was like a whack-a-mole thing where, like, if you push down the one end, the other one would go up. You could never, it was physically impossible, and I tried so much when I was like 10 years old, to get them all even, and it was impossible to do it. That's how I feel the Penguins' lines are right now. The third line is fucking phenomenal right now. They, honestly, there were points in the game where I'm like, just put the third line out there for the power play. Second line, invisible. Zucker, only time I heard his name called was when he was taking penalties. Rust, only time I saw him was when he was on the penalty kill. Malkin, only time I saw him was when he was turning over things on the power play. You need to balance out the lines. That's how you win Stanley Cup championships. We're only two games in, I know, but Malkin is in his, what, 17th season? 16th season? He needs to really step it up just overall, and I don't know. I'm getting concerned. Evan Rodriguez is starting to get the Dominic Simone treatment, already two games in on Twitter. He can't finish, even though there's been a lot of, you know, grade A chances for him to put the puck in the back of the net. Hasn't really happened so far. Matheson, he got rocked by Abe Kubel, and I'm going to come back to that later when I go with my projected lines, what I would do for next game. But the Penguins get a power play out of it, don't do anything for it, and then Travis Konecny finishes off the hat trick. He kicked another one in, not intentionally, hopefully not intentionally. You never know with the Flyers, but there was no review for either of them. But why were neither of them at least reviewed? And then DeSmith was pulled with just a little bit over 2 minutes left, and then Lindblom scored the empty netter. The Penguins lose this one 5-2, and it really is a frustrating loss just overall. Let's see if I had anything else here written down in my notes. Malkin is struggling. Love the third line. No goals were Jari's fault. Too many men penalties. Chris Letang. Chris Letang was awful tonight. I mentioned in the first game that Matheson struggled in his debut. We don't need to put that much pressure on Matheson. He was brought in. He was playing on the third pair. Chris Letang is our best defenseman, though. Maybe John Marino now. He played awful tonight. He was on the ice for all five goals. And the turnover that he had on the Konecny goal, shorthanded. He went up the rush with Jankowski and Tanev. Okay. But you got to pick what you're going to do there. He tried to have his cake and eat it too there. He tried to play back, and he also tried to play forward at the same time, and that led to a goal. And the Penguins' core over the past 10 years has been Crosby, Malkin, Letang. One of those players will have to be the first one to leave the organization. They're not all going to leave at once. I couldn't see that happening. The Penguins would go from decent to just train wreck. Letang might be the first player. He is, I think, next year an unrestricted free agent. I'm not going to say anything about what I think is going to happen with Letang, but he's declining. And now that the Penguins have Marino, I don't know. But, yeah, that's a topic for another day. Now, to try and get a little sappy here, I came to an epiphany just in the third period there with the Penguins, and that is this season might be a tough season. And I know other fan bases will be like, oh, boo-hoo, you guys got three Stanley Cups in this era. For the better part of a decade, the Penguins have been good, and this might be the year that the Penguins missed the playoffs, and I've gone on record saying it before. The Penguins technically didn't even make the playoffs last year, if you want to consider the play-in round as its own separate thing. So I'm going to be writing an article now. I thought of it just in the third period. Everyone knows the seven stages of grief, right? Shock, denial, anger, bargaining, depression, testing, and acceptance. I think the Penguins are going through this right now. With the thing that started this being the idea that the Penguins may not be Stanley Cup champions anymore. Shock is the Evgeny Kuznetsov goal when he scored in 2018 against the Penguins and eliminated the Penguins, and the Capitals beat the Penguins. Denial is the couple days after where you're like, oh, boo-hoo, the Capitals got lucky, blah, blah, blah. Anger is when the Capitals won the Stanley Cup in 2018. Bargaining is when we traded Phil Kessel and we wanted to maybe bring in Galchenyuk to try and keep that cup, you know, team alive. And depression is getting swept by the Islanders in four straight games. Testing is what the Penguins did last year. They were devastated by injuries, yet they were atop the league and would have marched into the playoffs in a typical season. And they tested us saying that, well, what are we going to do here? And then they lost to the Canadiens. And I think we're right about here right now. And the majority of Penguins fans needs to realize that, of course, the Penguins can't win the Stanley Cup every year. It may be time for a small rebuild or retool. And I know we are two games in here, but I don't know. I'm just saying this overall right now, at the beginning of the season, that this year might be hard for the Penguins and the Penguins fans, especially the bandwagoners that came in 16 and 17 and thought this team was amazing and everything. You Steelers fans that are here, sometimes the Penguins can lose too, just like the Steelers do. What I'm trying to say is that I guess the Penguins missing the playoffs wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. And I know, again, we're early in this, but we need to be getting towards the acceptance phase and kind of do what the Chicago Blackhawks did in terms of we need to get prospects. And I'll preach that to the day I die, is that the Penguins need to stop trading with their first round picks. Kasperi Kapanen, Jason Zucker, Ryan Reeves, Derek Brassard, they're not worth first round picks. Phil Kessel was, though, but Penguins don't have prospects. And if they continue to play like this, and then if Letang falls off, and then if Malkin falls off, like we're seeing now, we might only have Crosby left, and we might have to surround him with like Sam Lafferty and Evan Rodriguez, barely to make the playoffs and then get kicked out. But anyways, that's my rant overall for the night. I know we're only on game two of these PFRs, but I'm really concerned about the Penguins just overall as a franchise. But I'm not scared. I have been a Penguins fan since I was 8 years old, and I've still never seen them miss the playoffs, which is tremendous. The Penguins, again, three Stanley Cups in my lifetime. And in the Crosby era, five in their history. We have a lot to be grateful here in Pittsburgh. And if the Penguins don't make the playoffs this year, and if they play like they did tonight, there's always the 2016-2017 team videos that you can go look back on.
Real quick, here's what I would do if I was Sullivan. I'd put Zucker back on the first line. We got him to play with Crosby. He's looked invisible. Why not? I want to put McCann on the second line, switch him out. Not that he was bad with Jankowski and Tanev. It's just that Jankowski and Tanev were the main contributors to that third line. So why not put him on the second line, trying to get a spark going there? Lafferty has looked good despite, you know, limited ice time. So throw him on the third line there. And also, I'm scratching Sevier and I'm putting Drew O'Connor in just to spice things up. Doing Moletang, Pedersen, Marino, of course. Matheson, I think he should take a bench or take a seat. Not only because, you know, he hasn't looked great, but also because of the hit that he took tonight. Maybe just take one game off. Let CC come back in, and then Rui to look good enough that he won't get scratched again. And then go back to Jari. None of the goals tonight were his fault. So there's my take on what I would do if I was Sullivan. Also, an update on Sean Couturier. He apparently has to have an MRI right now. So best of luck to him. But, yeah.
Real quick, I'm going to plug my Twitter here, at OwenKreps85. I'm going to be answering PFR questions after every game if I get a decent amount of replies to one. I asked tonight, and I got a reply from Joe, who's a good supporter of this channel. He asks, when Cappy comes back, who sits? I think the answer is Colton Sevier. I have not seen much out of him just overall. I still don't understand why the reason he was there in that Hornquist trade would have much been better if it was just Matheson for Hornquist. That's my answer. I don't know where you put Kapanen immediately. You'll probably put him with Crosby, but yeah. Again, follow me at Twitter at OKreps85 if you want to ask me some PFR questions after the game.
But that is it for this one. Sorry if I got a little off topic there. The Penguins play Washington this Saturday or Sunday. Today's Friday, so it would be Sunday. Believe that's a matinee game. But I'll be excited to see Zdeno Chara, Connor Sherry, and Justin Schultz in Penguins uniforms there. I'll catch you all on that one, and I'll see you guys then. If you like this video, be sure to like, subscribe, comment, sub for Subspace, all that good stuff. And yeah, see you guys then.